Narendra Modi. As you know, he is on track for another term. But why? Why is he still popular despite everything that's happened, all the challenges in the last 5 years?
Thank you for having me. First of all, it must be noted that this is a truly remarkable victory. This is probably one of the first times, this is actually the first time in history that a non-Congress formation is coming back to power after a full term for a second term, and not just an ordinary second term. This is a second term where they not only have consolidated, but have at this point in time managed to in fact increase their margin of victory over 5 years ago. Back in the 90s and 2000s, there was a very popular phrase when we discussed Indian politics. The term was anti-incumbency. Indians had a habit of rejecting their politicians after they had spent five years in office. This is an important occasion where not only has India voted for our prime minister, for the incumbent government, but done so resoundingly. To the question of why, I think there are a number of factors. First and foremost, one mustn't forget that the Prime Minister himself is a very, very popular figure. He is charismatic, he attracts crowds, and has been able to do so consistently over the last five years. His government has been quite disappointing on many of the critical issues that he had been voted into power for back in 2014. He had talked about growth, he had talked about development, he had talked about jobs, he had talked, most importantly, in Hindi it's called Vikas, Sabka Vikas, he had talked about inclusive growth. His governance over the last 5 years has been extremely checkered. India is today in a deep economic crisis. Jobs have not matched expectations. In fact, by all accounts, India is in a serious unemployment crisis. Our farmers came to the streets repeatedly over the last 2 years. So when it comes to its overarching performance on the economy, this government hasn't performed yet well. Yet, the people of India, I think, have still firmly believed that this Prime Minister and his government are better placed to resolve the challenges of India than the opposition. It's important to note that the opposition,
you see it with this election victory, and you also see it with the market performance. You know, the share prices going up in India, despite the economic distress of the last 5 years.
Yeah.
The markets believe in Modi. The people have turned out and voted for Modi. And now to the question of what's next, because there's some concern about how he's going to use, and his party is going to use, this mandate that we have. Modi on Twitter said that, you know, together we're going to build a strong and inclusive India. But will there be more inclusion, or could there be more division, sectarian division, as many are fearing?
Well, let's not forget that even though the Prime Minister is extremely popular, he ran a very divisive campaign. This was not a campaign about performance of the past, and this was not a campaign about the promise of the future. This was very much a campaign that was deeply polarized, that was deeply communal and sectarian in its tone. And in fact, through the course of the campaign, the BJP has even managed to mainstream what used to be fringe elements like Sadhvi Pragya Thakur, who has now won Bhopal with a resounding majority. So this was very much a campaign about achieving ideological dominance. That has always been an extremely important and central part of the BJP's project. How the Prime Minister chooses to interpret this mandate now is, I think, an open question. At one level, you could argue that perhaps he may think that the ideological project is now won. And there is no doubt, and no matter what his government has said through the campaign, he is inheriting a weakened economy, and he needs to focus on that. Otherwise, India's economy is going to be in deep trouble. So there is a slim chance that Vikas may now be his focus. However, we must not forget that through this campaign and over the last 5 years, his government has unleashed in society a very, very deep and pernicious force. And the ability to contain it this campaign is
Yamini, but as you laid out, a number of challenges ahead for Narendra Modi as he leads India 2.0 with this new mandate. Yamini, thank you so much indeed for joining us.